Welcome to the session on expressing infinite solutions for trig equations. So that's when you solve the trig equations, you're going to get infinite solutions. How do you write that down? All right. Now, essentially what happens is trig functions are periodic, so there are going to be infinite solutions pretty much almost all the time unless you have some kind of restriction that you're given beforehand. So let's take a look at an example. This is the equation y equal cosine of x, and suppose we say let cosine of theta be y, so specifically when y is a half, how do you solve that? Well, I've got a graph up here, and suppose right around here is a half, so if you look at the intersection of the cosine graph with the line y equals a half, you can see there's going to be an awful lot of solutions. There's going to be one here, so right there. There's going to be one here, so this angle. There's going to be one here, so this angle when you drop down. One here. I mean, you can go on and on and on. So there's your... this is what gives rise to your infinite solutions. So how do we handle that? Well, let's take a look. When you actually go to solve this, you would say theta equals cosine inverse, or inverse cosine of a half, and your solutions then are going to be here at pi over 3, but remember, there's another solution over here, 5 pi over 3. So this is your, what I call your calculator solution, although your calculator wouldn't really give it to you as pi over 3. Of course, it would take 3.14 or whatever and divide it by 3. Here's your other solution we've talked about. So now how do I keep going through all these? So here's the pi over 3 solution. This is the 5 pi over 3 solution. And essentially what happens, let's focus on pi over 3. The pi over 3, if you basically just look at all the coterminal angles, they're all going to be solutions. So if you keep adding 2 pi or subtracting 2 pi, you're going to get all those solutions. And essentially that's like going way over here. If you add 2 pi, this is the one you're going to get. And for 5 pi over 3, if you add 2 pi, this is the next solution you're going to get. Okay? So let's look at it arithmetically. So any coterminal angle, we're going to focus on the solution pi over 3. Remember, any coterminal angle will be also a solution. So if you take pi over 3 and add 2 pi, let's do the fraction work, get the common denominator. So that's 7 pi over 3. And then you could say, well, that's just adding one revolution. What if I add 2 revolutions, or 2 times 2 pi? Then that's pi over 3 plus 12 pi over 3, which is 13 pi over 3. And you could keep going ad infinitum. Suppose I add 3 revolutions, or 3 times 2 pi. That's pi over 3 plus 18 pi over 3. So I get 19 pi over 3. So I could keep going on and on. Well, remember, coterminal angles go in both directions. I could have pi over 3 minus a revolution, so minus 2 pi, which is going to be pi over 3 minus 6 pi over 3, or negative 5 pi over 3. And I could do pi over 3 minus 2 revolutions, or minus 2 times 2 pi. So pi over 3 minus 12 pi over 3, negative 11 pi over 3. And then pi over 3 minus, let's say, 3 revolutions. So doing the fraction work. Okay, so again, you could keep doing this in the other direction. Keep subtracting revolutions of 2 pi. So hopefully what you see is a pattern, and that pattern is that we started out with pi over 3, and we're adding a certain number, whole number, of revolutions of 2 pi. So, or multiples of 2 pi. So here it's understood k is an integer, and remember, an integer is a whole number, can be positive or negative. Now, generally, you can write it this way. People tend to like to write it 2k pi. Honestly, there's no difference. It's just a little prettier. Okay. Now, of course, if you did the same thing for 5 pi over 3, you would see the same thing, same basic pattern. Instead of pi over 3 plus 2k pi, you'd have 5 pi over 3 plus 2k pi. So what are your solutions? Well, I say, I call it a generator. What we have just come up with are generators for specific solutions, but the generators actually encompass all the solutions. So I would have theta equals pi over 3 plus 2k pi, and theta is equal to 5 pi over 3 plus 2k pi. Okay, same pattern. Now, again, I call these my generators. Now, that's my word. That's not mathematically accepted. That's just my word. That's because now you can actually get specific solutions by substituting integer values for k. So again, we'll work with pi over the generator with for pi over 3. Suppose we look at the pi over 3 plus 2k pi. Let me show you some examples of how do you get those specific solutions. Well, again, you just put in integer values of k, whatever you want. You can put in 0, 500, negative 20, doesn't matter. So we'll start with some that most people would do. So you'd have theta equals pi over 3 plus 2 times 0 pi. Remember, 0 goes in the place of k. And you'll get just pi over 3. Let's try another value like negative 2 for k. So you get pi over 3 plus 2 times negative 2 pi. And you'll get pi over 3 minus 4 pi, which is pi over 3 minus 12 pi over 3, which is the negative 11 pi over 3. And hopefully you'll recognize that as one of the solutions we got. And suppose k is 3. Theta equals pi over 3 plus 2 times 3 pi equals pi over 3 plus 6 pi. So that's pi over 3 plus 18 pi over 3 or 19 pi over 3. Again, another solution to hopefully recognize. So again, though, you could keep going on and on infinitely. Okay. Now let's take a look at another example. Suppose you're looking at tangent of theta equal to negative 1.2. All right, so when you solve this and you say theta equals the inverse tan of negative 1.2, and your calculator gives you negative 0.8761 radians. Okay, we saw, well, you can check out another session on finding the other trig solutions, but we're going to have to do that. So our first solution, which came from our calculator, was here at negative 0.8761. And then there's going to be another solution over here. So this is our calculator solution. Here's our other solution. And that's going to be pi minus 0.8761, or 2.2655 radians. Now, what you can see, though, is that once you have a solution, say we look at the calculator solution right here. So I put a little star there, calculator solution. The other solution is exactly pi away, a distance of pi. And once you're on this other solution, to get to another name for the calculator solution, is you'd have to travel another rotation of pi. So you can keep doing this, and once you're on the calculator solution, you go back to the other solution by going pi. So these solutions, the calculator solution and the other solution, as well as their coterminal angles, are basically equidistant from each other. They're pi away, and you can see that on the circle. So essentially what I would write for the generator, okay, is theta equal to negative 0.8761 plus k pi. So essentially what you're doing is you're starting with a solution. It really doesn't matter which one. In this case, I picked the calculator one, 0.8761. And then you add k times the distance between them. So that's your generator here. Okay. Let's take a look at another example. tangent squared of theta equals 1. Now I just want to point out this is the same thing as tangent of theta squared equal to 1. So therefore what I want to do to start solving for theta is to take the square root of both sides. So I want to take the square root of, and I'll go back to the first form, tangent squared theta, take the square root of both sides. And that'll give me the absolute value of tangent theta equal to, well, square root of 1 is 1. And then tangent theta is equal to plus or minus 1. So essentially that's going to give me two equations I have to solve. Tangent of theta equals the positive 1, let's say, I'll put that for emphasis, and the tangent of theta equal to the negative 1. Okay, so what we know then is theta is the inverse tangent of 1, and again, that's asking for what angle between negative pi over 2 and pi over 2 is the ratio y over x equal to 1. If you ask the calculator that, it will give you pi over 4. It'll just do it in its give you a decimal answer for pi over 4. But essentially, you're here. The other solution is going to be over here at 5 pi over 4. And this will be the calculator solution if you put it in there. And then if you look at the other equation, tangent of theta equal to negative 1, you're looking for where is the ratio y over x equal to negative 1? Well, technically your calculator solution will be here at negative pi over 4, or you could call it, the calculator has to give you negative pi over 4, because theoretically it has to be an answer between negative pi over 2 and pi over 2, but you could say 7 pi over 4. And then the other solution is going to be here at 3 pi over 4. Okay. And so if you put it all together, here's essentially what you have. These and these. You have pi over 4, 3 pi over 4, 5 pi over 4, 7 pi over 4. And these are equidistant from each other. So you want to know, well, what's the distance from pi over 4 to 3 pi over 4? Well, subtract them. 3 pi over 4 minus pi over 4 is 2 pi over 4. And if you reduce that, that's pi over 2. What's the difference from 3 pi over 2, I'm sorry, 3 pi over 4 to 5 pi over 4? Well, subtract them. 5 pi over 4 minus 3 pi over 4 is 2 pi over 4. 2 pi over 4, when you reduce it, is pi over 2. What's the distance between 5 pi over 4 and 7 pi over 4? Well, again, subtract them, you'll get pi over 2. What's the distance between 7 pi over 4 and the next answer that you would get? You would see it's pi over 2. So these are equidistant from each other. And, or in this case, pi over 4 would be 9 pi over 4, but you'll, you know, cotemporal angle for pi over 4. Eventually, you'll see that these are all pi over 2 away from each other. So how do I express a generator that captures all of them at once? Well, again, start with any angle. Doesn't matter which one you picked. You could pick pi over 4, 3 pi over 4, 5 pi over 4, 7 pi over 4. Most people would pick the pi over 4. And then you would add k times the distance between them, which is pi over 2. That is your generator. Okay? So, hopefully then, let's take a look at this generator so you can see that it really does pick up all the solutions. Let's take a look at theta equal to pi over 4 plus k times pi over 2. Let's just put in some values of k to get specific solutions. When k is 0, I get theta is pi over 4 plus 0, or just pi over 4. That was our first one that we recognized. When k is 1, theta is pi over 4 plus 1 times pi over 2, which is pi over 4 plus 2 pi over 4. And look, there's my 3 pi over 4. When k is 2, theta is pi over 4 plus 2 times pi over 2, which is pi over 4 plus 4 pi over 4. There's my 5 pi over 4. And we'll do, you could keep going. Let's just do this last one, though. So you see that all of them are captured. It's pi over 4 plus 6 pi over 4 is 7 pi over 4. Okay. And obviously the next one's 9 pi over 4 and so on and so forth. But, so you see that this is it really does work. And so your generator is pi over 4 plus k pi over 2. In general, here's the pattern for writing your generator. And this is, of course, if the solutions are equidistant. So, if solutions are equidistant, to write the generator, you start with a solution, most people use the calculator solution, plus k times the distance between solutions. Understood where k is an integer. Okay. So then just recapping this a little bit. The first one we had solutions here, pi over 3 and then 5 pi over 3. And when I say equidistant, well, when I look at the distance it takes from pi over 3 to 5 pi over 3, that's not the same as going from 5 pi over 3 back to pi over 3 or another name for pi over 3, the next coterminal angle. Those distances are clearly not the same. So I can't use one generator to capture all solutions that both those angles would generate. So in that case, I have to handle pi over 3 separately, right? And I have to say pi over 3 plus 2k pi, and here 5 pi over 3 plus 2k pi. So in essence, I have two separate generators because the solutions are not equidistant. Then, so that was our first example, right? In our second example, we solved tangent of theta equal to negative 1.2. And what we saw, we got these solutions. We got here, negative 0.8761, and we got over here, 2.2655. But we saw these are equidistant. The distance from negative 0.8761 to 2.2655, and then from 2.2655 to the next name that would be given to negative 0.8761, that distance is pi. And it doesn't matter which direction we go in, counterclockwise or clockwise, it's either positive pi or negative pi. That's why we use k as an integer. So the integers could be positive or negative. So again, the generator we got then was negative 0.8761. That's the A solution plus k times pi. So there's k times the distance. The equal distance. Okay? And then in our third example that we did, we saw tangent squared theta equal to 1, and we saw that when we put it all together, we got here, 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 so pi over 4, 3 pi over 4, 5 pi over 4, 7 pi over 4, right? And that these were the same distance apart at pi over 2, pi over 2, pi over 2, pi over 2. So the generator was pi over 4 plus k times pi over 2. So there's my A solution, meaning any solution, and then you have k times the distance, the equal distance. Okay, so there's your generator. That's the pattern. And that finishes this session. Thank you for listening.